and these papers and this check piece. I carry all these things, my shoes and socks also, but along with all these dirty things I say I am walking. So our ignorance makes us call all these things I am. Similarly, we use the word for the body. We say, my hand is paining. That shows the hand is not I am. And where is the demarcation? Where the I am exists? This not this body. No part of the body is I am. The body is with me. That is what the philosopher thinks. That is what the philosopher thinks. Therefore, he is wrong always. The body is not with me, but the body is a part of me. That's the truth. It comes out of me, just as the ice block comes out of water. The ice water is in no way different from the water. The ice block is in no way different from water, but yet it floats on the surface of water. Similarly, from the I am in you, this body comes out. Every minute and second it is being constructed like that. So it is not yourself. We have our own thoughts. They are not ourselves. But many times we identify ourselves with our thoughts and we are involved. Just as when we are with a friend who is an idiot, when we go to another friend's house with an idiot friend, and when this idiot friend goes into the house and into the kitchen and begins to tackle with all the things in the house, break some things, burn some things, then what will be your position? Ridiculous. So if you identify yourself with your own thoughts, you are involved. You are many times ridiculous, because unconsciously you have identified yourself with your own intelligence, with your own philosophy, with your own beliefs, which are not yourself. So we should have two headings. Always you should be aware of the two things. What is the real I am of you? What is mine? That is belonging to me. You should never confuse between the two things. Here, money comes under mine, because it comes and goes. Even it goes, we are living. The houses, garments, and valuables, radio, TV, all these things, they are mine. They are not I am, and also body. See, is the hair myself or mine? Even when the barber cuts it, we are living. So it is mine and not myself. Even if the doctor cuts a part of our body, we are living. So body is not ourselves. And gradually, in course of time, we will come to understand that even when death cuts our body from ourselves, we are there. Therefore, we are not our body. Then our thoughts, they are not I am, because they come and go. Even when they are not there, we are there. Our emotions, it's not ourselves. Our relationships, they are not also ourselves. Suppose I say, she is my wife. Is she wife to me, or to herself is she a wife? If we take a little blood from her body, send it for medical examination, there is nothing like wife found in the blood. If she were to be the wife, she must be a wife of her own. But she is the wife of her husband, and the husband is not a husband to himself. So our relationships exist in our mind, and they are not part of ourselves. And then the mind, it's not ourselves, because even when the mind is not there, we are living. For example, sleep. Then where are we? You have to gradually go step by step. That is why it is compared with the climbing up of steps on a mountain. And then as you climb up more and more, you will find that which is really I am. It is described as the self-luminous. Luminous. That is the only one that is living. And all the other thing is living because of it. it is wrongly translated into other languages as burning bush. Moses went up the mountain and he found a self-luminous plant, a center of light. And then he talked to that light. And then he asked him, "What is your name? Suppose I go to Egypt. There they ask me, 'What is the name of your God?' Then he said, 'I am that I am.' Is it that answer that the burning bush gave? Is it the same answer? In the Old Testament, in the book of Exodus, is it the same answer or not? Please tell me if it is the same answer. No. Once again, go and read. Go home and read again. It is a little bit different. Tell him, and this sentence is given. If anyone asks you, what is the name of your God, tell him, 'I am that I am.' That is, wherever you go, whoever asks you who God is, if you speak of God in third person, you are speaking of your own impression of God and not God. If the God has asked Moses, 'My name is I am that I am,' then you know what Moses would have done. He would have gone to the Pharaoh of Egypt, and when he asked, 'What is the name of your God?' he would have answered, 'He is that he is.' So God is careful. He never said, 'My name is I am that I am.' He said, 'Tell him I am that I am.' What does that mean? Everyone should tell him, tell the other person, that what I am feeling as my own existence, feeling what I am existing as I am here, God, and the remaining man. This initiation is given there, but unfortunately we live in the 20th century, therefore we are dead to the Bible and Bible is dead to us. Let us once again be resurrected into the scriptures." So God said, "Tell him, 'I am that I am.'" So Moses said, "I am that I am." He never said, "He is that he is." When you speak about God, that he is God, it is not God, it is your own voice. It's not God's voice. It is passive voice. Passive voice. God speaks through you in active voice. So always, whenever you use the word "I am," there is a possibility of you are touching the real I am in you. So it is the key that leads you to God. That's the only word that leads you to God. And that's why after so many centuries, Jesus said, "I am the way." But unfortunately, the father and the bishop on the Sunday, they say, "He is the way." He is not the way, I am. In everyone, Christ should live. Not outside ourselves, on the walls or in the pictures. So, he said, "I am the way." Unless you speak it through your I am, you the man cannot be resurrected into him. Until then, he is crucified in you. You should live in him. Then he begins to live in you. Another prophet said, "Look to me, I look to you. Look to me." Here also, "me" means not him, but the "me" in you. You should close your eyes and look at "me" in you. So, whenever the Lord speaks, through whichever body he speaks in the same unmistakable language. You know who said this? He is called Sai Baba, who used to live in the 19th century in the near Bombay. He was also one of the incarnations of the Lord. And another said, "Know that I am looking you." The same thing. He is called Ramana Maharshi in South India. Lord Krishna said, "Take refuge in me, the I am of all. Make a total surrender to me." So, Every time he comes down to earth, in whichever body he likes, he uses the same term. In any language, the same term is used. That's why that term is called the catchword. That is the symbolic word used by man to call God and God to call man. In Sanskrit, it is called so means he, hum means I am. This is the meaning of the catchword. That is, out of ignorance, we say he, she, it. Whom we call he, there is only I am in every he or she. With that I am only everyone is living. So always, this is the catchword. It is always in singular number. We can't say we are. As human bodies and minds, we are there. But only the I am exists in everyone. Just like in many containers immersed in a bowl of water, the same water exists. Like the containers, we are there. Like the water in the containers, I am there. So it is only in singular number. This is what is also called the scripture. The scripture never means a book. Scripture is something about which the books are written. In the book called Secret Doctrine, Madame Blavatsky calls this the original scripture. And she also calls it the oldest manuscript. Manuscript ordinarily means a book written by human hand. But the significance here is the man in you is the script. He writes his own span of life as a book. That means the story of the human history proves the story of God history. Because man lives in God and God lives in man. And Blavatsky also says that it is the only copy of it now in existence. That means it always exists in singular number. And she says the book exists in the cave temples, in the caves, in the deep caves. That means innermost levels of consciousness. And if you can understand this as I am, then it is understood that you have known yourself. Otherwise, there are people who identify with one of these and call it I am. For example, some people, they identify themselves with their intelligence. They call it I am. And they call it I am. Some people identify themselves with their ideals. Their ideals are temporary, whereas they are the permanent principle, the Lord inside. And they live all through their life believing that they are their own ideals. And in the end, when their ideals are not realized, they die in sorrow. So, all these things should be set on one side. The I am, which is yourself, it includes all these things as the mind of yourself. But the I am is only I am and nothing else. It is the light which illumines all the other things. And it is the light from which everything comes. For example, in the empty space, there is one awakening in the form of I am. And there is the birth of one solar system. And in the morning, you will wake up from sleep into this consciousness. The moment you wake up, you exist as I am. Previously, you are existing, but the mind is not existing. Therefore, the little fellow mind cannot know that you are existing. You are beyond the mind, beyond the senses, beyond the body, beyond thoughts, beyond philosophies, beyond religions, beyond concepts. You are yourself. All these things come out just as your body comes out every moment from yourself. And again, just as you leave off your body when it is old, all these things go away. The ideas, the thoughts, religions and philosophies, they help us in their own time. They are not false. They are not bad. But they are like the pages in a calendar. The page in the calendar is not the month. But yet, it helps you to know the month. The calendar is not the year. Yet, it knows you to know the detail of the year. When the calendar is broken and torn off, the year is not gone. It is there. Once again, a new calendar is brought from the printing press. Calendars come and go, but the year goes on continuously. Similarly, the I am in every one of you, it shines eternally and permanently, whereas the religions and philosophies come and go from it and into it. And they serve their purpose. When the purpose is finished, they go into him. And the I am shines. The millions and millions of fellows, these bodies come from him. They live in him. He lives as the indweller of all these bodies. And then old age comes. These bodies go into him. Like that, this earth planet lives. It becomes old. It goes into him. Similar way, the solar system lives in him. It becomes old. It goes into him. Similarly, these galaxies and millions of solar systems come and go from him and into him. So he is called the I am. Even in the solar system, there is one fellow called the solar existence. He says, I am. And then there is the planet. Every planet has its own existence called I am. The planet feels I am. On every planet there are millions of atoms. Every atom feels I am. It begins its own evolution. At a certain stage it becomes the human being. And then begins to feel his own existence. And makes his approach into his own I am. The human birth is allotted for this purpose. For all those who live on this earth, the human stage of evolution is the temple to which all the pilgrims gather. Because only in the human birth you begin to know yourself. And through a series of births and deaths, you begin to train yourself. You will gain mastery over your senses and mind. Again you will go into the mistake of intelligence and you will die. Again you will fall in the right line. And after some births and rebirths you will know what compassion is. What God's love is. When you begin to know, it begins to flow through you. Then the purpose of your evolution is finished. You will know yourself. You will know the real meaning of the I am in you. This sacred part of the story happens in the human birth. It is for this purpose the human birth is given to living beings. It is for this purpose the wise people say that it is a great opportunity. We are expected to utilize the opportunity. Make the best use of it. Know that this is the training ground. That this is the real college and this is the real university. The temple of learning. Where we are trained by the nature, by the planet Earth, and by the other planets and the solar system, and by our fellow beings, by the people around us, by the law of nature, by the properties of matter and mind, all these things come to our aid. They lead us on through pain and pleasure towards the required direction. When we begin to feel our own real existence, and when we begin to gravitate towards our own I am, and then we reach the highest light, this I am in everyone. The purpose of the evolution on earth is completed. Then we will be living in human bodies, just as I mentioned yesterday and day before, not living for ourselves, but living for the planet Earth and to do something for others and other living beings. This is what is called knowing thyself. And for this purpose, we are given a sevenfold existence, which I mentioned yesterday. Material body, force called prana. The first is called anna or matter. The second is called prana or force. The third is called manas or mind. The fourth is called buddhi or will. The fifth is called man or nirvana plane. That is true I am. The sixth is called the planetary I am, paranirvana plane. That is the God in man. The seventh is the I am of the solar system, maha paranirvana plane. The man in God. These are the seven states that are existing in us. And we begin our human evolution in existing in the first three planes along with the animals. And the plants exist the only in the first two planes, that is matter and force. And the minerals exist only in the first plane. So the first plane is the plane of mineral consciousness. The second plane is the plane of plant consciousness. The third plane is the plane of animal consciousness, where the mind and senses are separated from the rest. In the plants, the mind and senses are not separated. For example, if you pluck a leaf from a plant, the plant has pain, but there is no location to the plane, to the pain. The whole plant pains. But in an animal or a human being, if you pick like this, there is a location of the pain. There will not be a total pain. That is because the brain, the mind and the senses are separated. That is what we call the animal consciousness, which is also common to us. And food, drink, sleep, fear and sex are common to the humans and the animals. Then the next fourth plane, that is the plane of will or buddhi. It makes us different from the animals. With the capacity of buddhi, we will be able to feel our own existence. For the first time, we begin to feel that we are existing. The dog never knows that it exists. It knows its appetite. It knows its master. It knows its food. It knows its pain. But it cannot know that it is existing. So it is the human being first who begins to know that he exists. And then the whole journey takes place. But also in group consciousness. That means you are in Lyon, I am in India, he is in America. Three of us are continuously working. We will be together working, feeling the same thing. When one of us is unhappy, the other two feel that he is unhappy. When one of us get a glorious revelation of new idea, the two others get the flash. This is what is called group living. It is not living in a physical group. It is also called soul consciousness. It is also called ashram. Many people think that ashram means a hermitage where criminals gather. Wives who leave husbands and husbands who left their wives